Aloha. Michael Kumukau Ohali, Native Hawaiian cultural practitioner, and we're here to discuss the Shortcut Caves. Most in particular, Kahau Pahau by Waipahu Depot Street, which you will be seeing films of as the rail digs to break through the Kahau Pahau Shortcut Cave, which in 2011 and 2012, we brought the information to HART Rail where the location was of this cave and how to avoid it under the programmatic agreement that they said they would. And in fact, they said nothing was going to be drilled there. And here we are. They're drilling at Waipahu Depot Street in two locations towards the Diamond Head side of the stoplight. And they're drilling where I told them not to drill. And I warned them on October 6th, and they said we did everything in the programmatic agreement, which was lying to me. And we tried to protect this TCP, Traditional Hawaiian Cultural Property, because it also is a continuation of habitation for sharks in the Ana Caves. And yet they failed to do what the programmatic agreement said they should do. And we have a map here. And this map shows what I brought in for years, the Kahau Pahau Caves, which is here, that crosses by Waipahu Depot Street. And you will see a continuation of this in her brother Kahi'uka's cave, which is by Leeward Community College, where you see the huge rail bridge that goes over the H1 freeway going to Wai'anae, to the right side of the berm. There is a big sinkhole because they've diverted the underground water stream by putting that massive bridge there. And we have tape and footage of that. And I've got, of course, we brought in, where you see these red lines on the map, all the Shark God caves and Eel Boy caves intersecting years ago. And we let them know. And we put in for historical federal recognition. And they've stalled us. And they've tried to stop us. And the programmatic agreement under law says that these places are special, should be identified, should be protected. But that is not what is going on with the HART Rail staff. And they continue to make excuses, continue to misdirect, continue to say, this does not exist, we don't have to worry about that. When the law states, and the programmatic agreement of the HART Rail Authority states, they must protect this under Stipulation 9B. They're supposed to protect this, and Stipulation 12D. When new information is brought to the table. And we've consistently showed them where these places are. They've consistently tried not to pay attention to this and consistently have said they're following the programmatic agreement. They give us empty talk and say we're doing consultation. They've consistently kept the public who are paying for this taxpayer, federally funded property and state funded, city council funded taxpayer project, and they refuse to follow the law. And we've tried to hold them to following the law under the programmatic agreement as a consulting party, Michael Kumukau Ohali and the Kanihili Hui cultural organization, to make them follow the laws of the state, the federal government, and the programmatic agreement, which they've consistently undermined. So we are coming here today to let the public know, vis-a-vis YouTube and also Olelo, public broadcasting, to let the people know who are paying for this, they're not following the law. They're given due notice with due care in due time specifically, and give lip service to that and still destroy Hawaiian traditional cultural properties, which is a Hawaiian cultural resource, which is in the public good and in the public interest, which they refuse to follow. So this is something that we need the public to get juiced on, to say this is wrong, and they should not, they should be held accountable to the letter and the spirit of the law. And we need your support. We need you to write to your city council people, your state representative, House and Senate, and your federal, state council people who are representing a state senator, federal U.S. senator, and U.S. Congress representative in Congress. This is abhorrent to the laws that were stated to protect Hawaiian culture, which they are flagrantly, flagrantly disregarding, even though they've been given specific notice where these things are by newspaper articles in the 1870s and documentation from the Great Mahele 170 years ago, 1847, 1848. So we need your support. We need people to put some skin in the game and say this is not correct with my taxpayers' money, that we need to follow the law. We need to protect Hawaiian native cultural sites as wahipana, sacred places that are important, because the Hawaiian culture and tradition is worthy to be proliferated and taught, and that it is worthy because it was here before the Westerners came here. It had survival strategies for the ancient Hawaiians, and it was part of the religious cultural value sets that are under law in our state constitutional, Article 12, Section 7. We will not overregulate or destroy Hawaiian religious or cultural practice for the benefit of the health of the Hawaiian people. And we need your support to do the right thing for the right reason. So this is a part of it. And the rail is not following up to the spirit and letter of their own agreements that they signed, that they would protect Hawaiian cultural sites as native Hawaiian cultural resources that were valuable. They're disregarding it in your name. And you need to know what is right and what is wrong. So please stand up and make your voices heard. I appreciate you following through to let them know your voice. Mahalo.
Please do inform them of Shad Khani's intervention with a letter. Could you describe us the status of that?
The powers that be try to discredit the scholarly documentation. They got a Hawaiian practitioner of kahili feathers, and what they did was they asked him to debunk the evidence that I brought to the table in the programmatic agreement sponsors, and he put out a letter stating that what I brought to the table was only oral tradition and had no finding of fact because it was just oral. The Hawaiian culture from the Kumulipo is an oral tradition. There is no Roman Catholic scribe writing in luminary documents that in the Western venue. All of our culture from the chants of Hiakapoliopele 1,060 years ago to Kualii's chant 600 years ago are all oral transmitted empirical knowledge that was put down. And so they got this cultural practitioner who's not a kahuna to say that what I brought to the rail and the facts that I brought vis-a-vis our Hawaiian culture and the chants and the Hawaiian newspapers were all antidotal, which is just storytelling, talk story, verbal transmission, and they don't count, which was the deeper part he was saying is Hawaiian tradition, oral tradition does not count. And it's open season for development because it's just the Hawaiian people's opinion. And it's not a fact under Western venue, Western law. This is abhorrent and it's a betrayal to our Hawaiian oral tradition as indigenous people. And so it's a clear hit piece to discredit our cultural practice and our cultural traditions that are oral, to shoot it down for the good of the grave of lust and greed, which is to drill baby drill and have no impediments, and whatever you bring in chants or in the kumulipo doesn't matter because it doesn't stand the test of rules of evidence according to Western documentation. And that cultural practitioner should know better. It was a hit piece and it was seen by every kanaka as a hit piece. And so we need you to speak up, to get involved and informed of what is happening in the rail. And what are the greater implications of, does the state have the right to destroy the Hawaiian culture just because it thinks it can? And the city, under the authority of HART Rail, be not accountable to the people, to the state constitutional laws, to its own programmatic agreement, just because it thinks it can get alternative voices to put down Hawaiian oral tradition and culture. So we need you to know what is going on and to speak up and put some skin in the game. I appreciate you following through. Mahalo.
And that's why we have this structure as the temple of the aqueduct of the grave of lust. This rail is the aqueduct of cash flow, the temple of Hawaiian empirical money flow to the banks of Del Bartier First Hawaiian Bank and Bank of Hawaii to bring in cash mortgages for the unions, for the masons, the plumbers, the carpenters union. The business of government is the business of the flow of money. This is the hub-spoke wheel approach from the airport to the suburbs of the track laying of the flow of cash flow, of the movement of people to justify bedroom communities of hundreds of thousands of people over 20 years of mortgages, over the shark god caves that were the foundation of these islands that were funneled from Kalihi to this side of the island for the foundation of the building of this island of Oahu. And this is the Western form of the grave of lust and greed. And it is done with the consent of government that justifies the taking of property to build this cash flow with transportation. So it's transporting not only people, but mortgages as a hub-spoke wheel approach of the foundation of building an economy vis-a-vis the union and government assistance. So this is what the true nature of what this is all about. It has nothing to do with exercising the taking away of the traffic jams or whatever. It's nothing to do with that. And so the approach that is done here is the flow of not water, like the aqueducts of Rome, because this looks like an aqueduct over Israel for the Roman Empire. No, this is the cash flow aqueduct through the hub spoke wheel approach of the capitalistic system that does not respect the individual or the individual right. It is that money rules the flow of government, and government's approach is that commerce and trade is the heart and flow of what government is all about. And that's why we have this structure as the temple of the aqueduct of the grave of lust and greed. Justify bedroom communities of hundreds of thousands of people over 20 years of mortgages.